Hello, my name is Jim Schall, and I am an instructor for Federal Highway Administration training delivered under the National Highway Institute. The National Highway Institute, or NHI, is the training branch of the Federal Highway Administration. The videos you're about to watch are based on some of the training courses developed by the National Highway Institute, in particular, the Introduction to Highway Hydraulics course, NHI course 135065, and the Culvert Design course, NHI course 135056. I've been an instructor for National Highway Institute training courses for 25 years. I completed my undergraduate engineering degree at Purdue University and did my master's and PhD at Colorado State. The videos are based on demonstrations and experiments that we do primarily in these two training courses, built around a portable flume. The flume is 6 inches wide and approximately 5 feet long and recirculates water from a 30-gallon sump. The videos, there are six of them to watch. The recommended order in which to watch those videos, first, open channel flow concepts, then grate inlets, culvert hydraulic concepts, hydraulic effects of culvert liners, aquatic organism passage design concepts, and energy dissipators for culverts. Thank you for your interest in Federal Highway Administration training. I hope you find this video series helpful in completing highway drainage design projects. This video will demonstrate the effects of liners on culvert performance. The purpose of the video is to see how a liner changes hydraulic performance primarily by looking at the change in headwater that will be detected by our stilling well. I have for the model a double barrel culvert. We'll only be using the rough barrel side, which simulates a corrugated metal pipe with an end value of 0.024. So I have a plug in the smooth barrel side. I have two liner models to demonstrate. The first one will model a slip liner. My culvert model is a 1:12 scale. I have a 2-inch diameter pipe in the model, meaning a 2-foot diameter pipe in prototype. This slip liner would be 6 inches smaller in prototype. It's a 1.5-inch pipe, or 18 inches in prototype, and that's a fairly common change to a slip liner to allow grout to be pumped into the annulus between the host and the liner pipe. I also have what we might call a close fit liner, which is a 1 3/4-inch pipe, or in my prototype dimension, equivalent to a 21 inch. We'll be looking at the changes in the roughness of the pipe. We're going from my end value of 0.024 to a value in both liners of a smooth barrel with an end value of, say, 0.012. So we're cutting the end value in half and comparing how that change interacts with the change in area that we see when we put a liner into a culvert. I have a couple different ways to terminate the liner. The models have a head wall with a groove end to allow different things to be input to the head wall. So my liner model has a ring on it that will allow it to recess into the socket on the end of the head wall, maintaining a KSB of about 0.2. I also have some extenders that I can put on the head wall to simulate what would happen if we terminated the liner outside of the host, which is not a preferred construction method, but I have seen it done. That changes the KSB from 0.2 to about 0.9, the way I'll be testing the model. So we'll run through this in outlet control initially. If you're not familiar with the concepts of outlet control in culvert hydraulics, please refer to the culvert hydraulic video, the FHWA culvert hydraulic video that goes through the differences between inlet and outlet control. Once the headwater stabilizes, we'll mark it with one of the O-rings on our stilling well, and then we'll proceed with the slip liner, which will be the pipe dropping down from a 2 foot to an 18 inch in prototype dimension, allowing enough space for grout injection around the annulus of that liner pipe. And the question is, when I stick the liner in, will the headwater go up or go down? It's commonly believed that a liner will improve the hydraulic performance, that the headwater would go down because we're changing the end value so dramatically. We're going from our 024 for our CMP pipe to an 012 for the smooth barrel. So let's see what happens. As we can see, the headwater is rising quite a bit. Once that stabilizes, I'll go ahead and mark that. But what this tells us is that the change in area on this particular model, going from a 24 inch to an 18 inch pipe, far outweighs the change in roughness. That in fact, the hydraulic performance doesn't improve, it gets worse. This is with a case of E, the entrance coefficient loss of about 0.2. I can change that by putting my liner extension on to a thin edge projecting, which has a case of E of 0.9. So my headwater's rising slowly, but I think we're stable enough we can try this. And we see a little bit more of an increase in the headwater. We don't see a big change. It was quite a change in the case of E. We went from 0.2 to 0.9. But in culvert hydraulics, in outlet control, the entrance loss is just one part of the energy loss. We have the entrance loss, we have the friction loss of the barrel, and we have the exit loss. The friction loss is typically the largest. The entrance loss doesn't change the hydraulic conditions too much in outlet control. When we go to inlet control, we'll see something different. But in outlet control, this case of E value wasn't a big change. So let's take this out and put the close fit liner in. We'll give it a minute to stabilize. And again, the close fit liner will change my barrel diameter from 24 inches to 21. Not as much of a change in flow area as we had with the slip liner. And we'll see how that impacts this trade-off between area and end value change. Federal Highways has done enough research on this to know as a rule of thumb that the smaller pipe sizes, like in my model, my 2 foot barrel, the area change is more important. That continues up to about a 48 inch pipe. The change in area is typically more important than the change in roughness. Above a 48 inch pipe, what is commonly believed starts to happen, which is that the smooth liner, particularly on a CMP pipe, will improve the hydraulic performance because in the larger pipe size, even for a slip liner, that normal 6-inch reduction in size to allow for grout injection is not as significant as it is at the smaller pipe sizes. So we're pretty stable on the headwater. Let's go ahead and put my close fit liner in and see what happens. And as expected, we see an increase, of course, not as much as we had with the slip liner because the area reduction is not as great. So I'll mark this one, and again, we'll put on the liner extension, meaning that the liner is terminated outside of the host, And there'll be a slight increase again, but because we're still in outlet control, we don't see as much of a change. In outlet control, we have all three energy losses, the entrance loss, the barrel friction loss, and the exit loss that account for the headwater performance. With a model in this configuration, I'm going to go ahead and raise the slope up to inlet control, and we'll see these changes in inlet control, starting with the liner extension. I'm going to vent this pipe only to make it transition to inlet control more quickly. And again, this idea of terminating the liner outside of the host is certainly not a recommended design practice. In addition to a hydraulic impact, changing the case of E, you have what is typically a thin edge projecting pipe projecting into the flow with assorted structural and buoyancy related concerns. So I'll start by marking this headwater, and then what we'll do is transition from the case of B of 0.9 to a bevel ring that will change the case of B to 0.2. So now we're in inlet control, we're flowing supercritical, we're on a steep slope, supercritical part full flow inside the barrel. The headwater is pretty stable. Let's take the liner extension off, slip the bevel ring into place, and we immediately see a reduction in the headwater. This is because in inlet control, conditions at the inlet are critical. That's why we call it inlet control, and changes we make at the entrance can dramatically change hydraulic performance. So it's clear from the demonstration, there's two primary points to remember, that the way you terminate the liner is important in terms of how the culvert will operate hydraulically in the field. When you allow the liner to project from the host pipe beyond the head wall, you change the case of E value and create this thin edge projecting entrance condition that has a small effect in outlet control, has a large effect in inlet control. By far, the preferred construction practice is to terminate the liner inside the host and use that grout to form a bevel at the entrance to the pipe. The second important lesson to remember is that while it's commonly believed that inserting a liner will improve the hydraulic performance, particularly on a rough barrel pipe because you're changing the end value, in fact, what we find is that's only true on the larger diameter pipes. If you're above a 60-inch pipe, 48-inch pipe, on into 60-inch pipe, a 6-inch change in pipe size, even for a slip liner, isn't that much of a change percentage-wise, and therefore the change in end value becomes very important. Smaller pipes below 48, and my model was in a prototype dimension, a 24, a 2-foot diameter pipe, we saw that the change in area was far more important than the change in end value. Thank you for your interest in Federal Highway Administration training. For additional information on culvert hydraulics and the effects of liners on culvert hydraulics, please refer to Hydraulic Design Series number 5, The Design of Highway Culverts by the Federal Highway Administration, and the accompanying NHI training course, NHI course 135056 on culvert design. And you can also use, to do any of these calculations and to evaluate these changes, the Federal Highway Administration software HY8 for culvert design, changing the barrel size, the end value, the entrance coefficient to evaluate how a liner might act in the field before it goes into construction.